The Xiaomi Mi Band 5 has been released and announced and brought out and made available for everybody. But in this episode, I want to talk to you about why I won't be buying one. Welcome back to another episode of STU'S Reviews. Without a doubt, some fanboys have probably gotten this far in the video already and are about to hit that dislike button and then go to the comments and put some kind of triggered statement in there. Well, stop for a second, because I have loved the Xiaomi Mi Band series forever. I've reviewed the Mi Band 2. I've reviewed the Mi Band 3. I've even reviewed the Mi Band 4. But I will not be reviewing or buying the Mi Band 5. And I want to talk to you about why I'm not going to be doing that and why I think potentially, if you are looking to buy one of these, you should stick with the Mi Band 4 if you live anywhere other than China.
China!
Now, seriously, I have loved the Mi Band series. They've always been fantastically priced, had an incredible feature set, and each single time they've brought out a Mi Band, it's definitely been a successive generational change. I'm pretty certain the original Mi Band didn't have a screen, and then obviously the Mi Band 2, they brought out one with a screen, and that was a fantastically priced little fitness tracker for what it did. The Mi Band 3 came out, and that was a slightly different design change and slightly brighter display for better use in sunlight. And then the Mi Band 4 came out, which was this incredible feature-rich device. It had an AMOLED display, it had all sorts of different tracking available on it that weren't available in the previous versions, even though it was in the same size body. And I loved the Mi Band 4. And honestly, I've loved them every single time. But the Mi Band 5, I really think that Xiaomi have dropped the ball on this one. Maybe not necessarily for Chinese customers, but certainly for international customers. And that's because a lot of the features that are going to be made available in China just will not be made available in international purchases. So UK, US, none of the features that are big selling points of the Mi Band 5 are going to be made available. So let's look at the changes. There are a few smaller ones that are hidden away that you might necessarily not know about. There are some bigger ones, and I'll get onto those big ones in a bit. But one of the big differences is the magnetic charging, which actually I really like. Now, those of you that have had Mi Bands in the past will know that they're plagued by a horrendous charging situation or system where you have to remove the actual device from the band and plug it in and sliding in this awful little awkward plastic thing. But that's a thing of the past, because the Mi Band 5 now has magnetic charging. And that has been on my feature request list for a long time for the Mi Band. So points for that one. But that's about it. It gets bad after this. So the screen is a bit of a trade-off. Although it's 20% bigger, it's got less colour. The Mi Band 5 only has a 16-bit colour display, whereas the Mi Band 4 had a 24-bit colour display. So the colours were more vivid, it displayed more true to life, rather than a standard sort of monitor setup that's on the Mi Band 5. It's not a big deal, and to be honest, the majority of you probably will never notice that being on such a small screen, but it's still a consideration. But on the flip side of that, you've also got a slightly brighter display on the Mi Band 5, and it goes up to about 450 nits, whereas the Mi Band 4 only goes up to 400 nits. Again, not a massive deal, but it could make a bit of a difference when using it in sunlight. So the screen, although it has a few little negative bits, has a couple of positive bits as well. But let's keep going down that rabbit hole, because some of the feature changes get even more strange. Next is the battery, which is actually smaller than the Mi Band 4. I don't know why. The Mi Band 5 has 125 mAh battery, whereas the Mi Band 4 has 135 mAh battery. Okay, fine, again, it's only 10 mAh you're missing, but on their website, it says quite clearly that the Mi Band 5 will give you 14 days battery life. It quite clearly states that as sort of, that is how long you'll get. If you put it in power saving mode, you can get 20 days battery life, but that's in power saving mode. The Mi Band 4 is advertised as standard at 20 days battery life, which I think I'm pretty certain I verified in my review. The fact is, the Mi Band 5, you're still getting a worse battery than you had in the Mi Band 4. Why? Why drop the battery life? Because the battery life was always a massive selling point of the Xiaomi miband series. Maybe I'm crying a little bit over spilt milk because, you know, it's not a huge deal. 4, 5, 6 days less. I still get 2 weeks of battery life out of the Mi Band 5. But it's still something you need to question. Why have they dropped the battery size? So those things are the small changes under the hood that might have gone unnoticed, but I think they're just as important to consider as some of the more glaringly obvious omissions in the Mi Band 5. Now, back when I reviewed the Mi Band 4, the one thing that I wanted over and over again was NFC compatibility. I wanted to be able to access the NFC chip in the Mi Band 4. I am hoping that the features in the Chinese Mi Band 4 will make it to the UK at some point. I mean, there's a tweet from Xiaomi that came out earlier on today, in fact, before I filmed this, and that said, hashtag found at Area 51, Mi Smart Band 4 with Google Pay NFC. So to me, that sounds like maybe it's something on their radar, maybe it's something they're thinking about. Will it ever appear in this particular iteration of the Mi Band? I don't know, maybe they'll save it for a Mi Band 5 at some point. But unfortunately, that wasn't the case. Of course, it had many other features that made me forget about that, and I wasn't that bothered because I thought, you know what, they'll probably bring it out in the Mi Band 5. And they did bring it out in the Mi Band 5, but not for us in the United Kingdom, nor in America, nor anywhere else, in fact, other than China. And that is so annoying. One of the biggest features of the Mi Band, I thought they would finally bring out to international markets, they haven't done. And I can understand why, because obviously the NFC inside the Mi Band 5 is designed to work with Xiaomi Pay or whatever it's called, their version of Apple Pay. Why couldn't they just give us access to this NFC to put our own cards or passes or locks or anything like that? Why did they not allow us access to it? Now, this doesn't mean that they might not eventually allow access to it, and if they do, I'll be the first one to be buying one. But right now, as they did with the Mi Band 4, they've included something great, but they've omitted it from international versions. It's just really annoying. I mean, there's an idea. They could have partnered up with a company like Curve, for example. If you don't know what Curve is a card that basically acts like all of your debit and credit cards in the UK. And it's a fantastic service, and I swear by them. I use it in everything. And in fact, I've done a review of Curve as well. And again, I'll leave that in the links so you can check that out yourself. But they could have partnered with someone like that to have the Curve card associated with the NFC chip on the device. It would have been pretty straightforward, I think. I'm not a coder or a designer, so I haven't got a clue. But as far as I'm concerned, they could have implemented something, but they chose not to. Another feature they've missed off is the SpO2 sensor. Why? I don't know. Could they add it in at a later date? God knows. They've also omitted the voice assistant. They've got the voice assistant available in the Chinese version of the Mi Band 5, but it's not in the international version. Which is a crying shame, because they have shown in the past that they can quite easily implement a voice assistant for international markets. Look at the Amazfit Verge, for example. They included Amazon's voice service in that. Actually, saying that, the voice assistant in the Verge took about 2 years for them to release, but they did in the end release it. So again, they could release some kind of integration with Amazon's voice service later on the Mi Band 5. But right now, right this second, some of the biggest features of the Mi Band 5 just aren't there. And you look at the price is £40 currently in the UK. Don't know what it is in America, but £40 here in the UK. You can get the Mi Band 4, which is pretty much identical in its feature set for the UK, for less than £25 on Amazon. So guys, listen, if you are thinking about buying a Mi Band 5, my advice is don't. Don't fuel this acceptance that we have to accept a product that has been released with a very, very small, tiny little feature changes. We should be turning around to Xiaomi and saying, no, enough is enough. Actually update your products so they work properly in the UK. And do you know what? I'm not angry. I'm just disappointed. And that's all for today. Not my usual type of content, because normally I would be doing a review right now, but my advice to you is stick with the miband 4. If you liked today's episode, don't forget to hit that like and subscribe, guys, and hit that notification bell if you want to find out some more. And I may review the miband 5 if they do decide to upgrade some of the features. I mean, like I said, it's not unheard of that these devices get updated 1 or 2 years down the road with some fantastic features. For example, look at the Amazfit Bip. That was purely Chinese for about a year and a half, and then all of a sudden they just dropped the English support for the Amazfit Bip, which was great. And like I said, the Amazon Voice Assistant for The Verge. So I'm hoping that one day they will update the miband 5 to be the product that I expected them to bring out. But other than that, get the miband 4 or wait for the miband 6, because you better have put NFC and voice assistant or something good in the miband 6, shall we? I'll see you back next time.